When attached to a life jacket bladder, the gas cylinder inside the bladder is permanently attached to the MA1. Inside the MA1, two arms joined by a paper element hold a coiled mainspring under tension. The paper element is located next to the hydrostatic valve. If the paper element's integrity is compromised by water entering the MA1 through the hydrostatic valve, activation happens in a fraction of a second. The arms pull the paper apart and release the spring. The spring turns an eccentric cam that drives a piercing pin directly into and then out of the gas cylinder. Gas is discharged into the bladder through the base of the MA1, providing full life jacket buoyancy within seconds. Some air will always remain in a life jacket's bladder even after vacuum packing. When the life jacket is submerged, if the air pressure inside the bladder and the MA1's hydrostatic valve is equivalent to the surrounding water pressure, the valve remains closed and no water can enter. Water can only enter the valve when the internal air pressure drops. What will cause this drop in air pressure? As the life jacket is submerged, water pressure squeezes the bladder, forcing the air inside up to where the pressure is lower, near to or above the surface of the water. When the vertical distance between the lowest point of the displaced air and the hydrostatic valve is about 10 centimeters, the air pressure in the valve is low enough to allow water to enter and activate inflation.